In his breast, a riot of conflicting emotions were raging the first great battle which was to point to the trend of the man's character. Would the selfish and the base prevail, or would the noble? With the thought of losing her, his desire for her companionship became almost a mania. To return her to her father and Von Horn would be to lose her, of that there could be no doubt, for they would not leave her long in ignorance of his origin. Then, in addition to being deprived of her forever, he must suffer the galling mortification of her scorn. It was a great deal to ask of a fledgling morality that was yet scarcely cognizant of its untried wings, but even as the man wavered between right and wrong, there crept into his mind the one great and burning question of his life: had he a soul? And he knew that upon his decision of the fate of Virginia Maxon rested to some extent the true answer to that question, for unconsciously he had worked out his own crude soul hypothesis, which imparted to this invisible entity the power to direct his actions only for good. Therefore, he reasoned that wickedness presupposed a small and worthless soul, or the entire lack of one. That she would hate a soulless creature he accepted as a foregone conclusion. He desired her respect, and that fact helped him to his final decision, but the thing that decided him was born of the truly chivalrous nature he possessed. He wanted Virginia Maxon to be happy. It mattered not at what cost to him. The girl had been watching him closely as he stood silently thinking after her last words. She did not know the struggle that the calm face hid, yet she felt that the dragging moments were big with the questions of her fate. "Well?" she said at length. "We must eat first," he replied in a matter-of-fact tone, and not at all as though he was about to renounce his life's happiness. "And then we shall set out in search of your father. I shall take you to him, Virginia, if man can find him."